हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द वेज टू अचीव आर्मेचर वोल्टेज वेरिएशन। इन दिस वीडियो वील सी वील लिस्ट आउट वेरियस मेथड्स फॉर अचीविंग आर्मेचर वोल्टेज वेरिएशन फॉर डीसी मोटर ड्राइव्स एंड आई विल डिस्कस वॉट लियोनार्ड मेथड इन डिटेल इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो। Now, the classification of different method is depending on the source. If the available source is AC, that is supply available for the motor is AC, then we have following methods. One is the very old method known as Ward-Leonard method. Second is a very old method which was used in old locomotives also, that is step changing transformers with uncontrolled or diode rectifier. And third is the latest method which is very popular these days, is that using control rectifiers which are using SCRs, so we can control using the firing angle control. Similarly, if the source is DC, that means generally battery or say solar supply is there, then we can use a DC to DC converters or choppers for speed controls. We are going to discuss each method in detail in subsequent sections. In this particular section, we are going to discuss the Ward-Leonard method, right? So here we already know the source is AC. So how Ward-Leonard method works? It is a very old method. It was actually introduced when there was no power electronics or all other devices were available. So this was one of the very old method. And this is the diagram. So here you can see in front of the screen that this red dotted line shows the motor which is to be controlled. The speed of this motor is to be controlled. Now the armature of this is supplied by another identical machine, but it is operating as a generator. So this green dotted line shows the identical machine which is operating as a generator. So output of this generator is fed as an input to this motor. So whatever is the output, it is as an armature voltage to the motor. And this generator is driven by a three-phase induction motor, which is using three-phase normal AC supply. So this is a constant speed machine. So it is running the generator. The excitation of generator is actually changed to change the output voltage VAG, which is now working as a armature voltage input to motor known as VAM. So by varying the excitation of generator, I can vary the armature voltage. So this is how armature voltage control is achieved, right? In addition, we can have a field control also, because this generator and motor are separately excited. So the motor is also having field winding. So I can exercise a field control if I wish to have a speed above rated speed, right? So this method was very popular, but it's very old method. These days, it is of no use. We'll see why. So the field excitation of generator is used to vary armature voltage of the motor. Speed above rated speed also possible with field control of the DC motor, which we have already discussed. It requires identical motor generator set separately excited. An induction motor gives constant speed to the generators, right? Now the pluses and minuses of this method. First point is that one of the oldest method of speed control. So it was there where the speed control was invariably required and cost was not an issue. This was the method used previously, years ago, not now. Wide range of speed control is possible. Almost you can say minimum to above rated speed is possible. That is the beauty of this method. Two additional machines are required just to have a speed control of a DC motor, separately excited DC motor. An additional DC generator and an induction motor is required. So this is a very costly affair, very costly method. As these three machines are there, so efficiency is also going to be less, because inefficiency or losses are going to take place in all these three machines. So this is a very inefficient method, a costly method, and is used only and only, was used rather, only and only when it was absolutely essential to have speed variation and cost was not an issue, right? So this is one of the way in which you can have armature voltage variation. Of course, this is an obsolete method. Please keep in mind, this is not what you use these days, right? That's all for the first method. We'll see about the same in our subsequent class, the other methods, right?